Hey, Dan, how's it going?
Hey, Siraj, mind if I ask you a few questions?
Let's do it.
All right, well, how much do you sleep every night?
About 6 hours.
Where do you live?
In Amsterdam.
Where did you study?
At Columbia University.
What's your favorite book?
The Road by Cormac McCarthy.
What is the coolest deep learning project you've seen?
OpenMined by Andrew Trask.
Do you need to know very complex math at the level of calculus or linear algebra to start on the path of deep learning?
No, in fact, you just need to know programming, and if you can code with Keras, you can do this stuff in 9 or 10 lines of code. If you want to get more advanced, then you'll use some math.
How long did it take you to get into machine learning?
It took me, I was on and off for about 3 years, but to really get started, it took me about 3 months.
I live in a developing country. How can I make a positive change here through machine learning?
There is always an opportunity to use machine learning in some way. Find a problem that you want to solve. That's the first step. And once you do, apply machine learning to it. You can always do that.
In order to master deep learning, is there any other language we should learn other than Python?
JavaScript comes in at a close second. And also Go is a great language.
Which courses did you take at uni that you would recommend?
At my university, it was a closed university, but online I could say a great course to take is the Udacity Deep Learning Nanodegree, as well as Andrew Ng's new deep learning course.
Can AI be used to retouch skin portions by removing blemishes, like with Photoshop?
Oh, for sure. Yeah, that would be a generative problem. So you'd want to use an autoencoder to encode that image, and then you would learn the latent representation, and then you could generate an image without the blemishes.
Which country would you like to visit most?
I'm really excited to go to India in 5 days, so I will be in India. I'm very excited.
And if you've started today, which learning resource would you use to master deep learning?
I wonder what I would use. My channel, for sure. My channel, and also I would look at Udacity and Coursera.
How can introverted or shy people improve their confidence to be more like you, as these traits are helpful in tech?
It just takes a lot of practice. I'm not naturally a super social person, but just by constantly putting myself out there in front of the world, being vulnerable, it definitely just builds up your confidence. So it's a discipline that you build up over time.
What drives you to create YouTube contents instead of working on some high-end AI or machine learning research independently or collaboratively with great minds of our time?
I would love to do a project that is put in the hands of millions of users. But it's kind of a sacrifice, right? Making content is my way of making impact. I could do one or the other. Ideally, I could do both. We'll see. We'll see where that goes.
Have you ever tried Clarify's cool image recognition technology, which is a direct competitor to Google?
I have. I think it's really easy to use, and thumbs up.
What do you think about independent startups competing with big giants in AI tech, such as Google, Microsoft, Amazon? And why would you prefer one over the other, such as Clarify versus Google?
There is definitely a space for startups, for sure. There's so many different exit strategies. There's so much different data that's available for small startups that you can use that Google or Amazon or the giants haven't used yet. The space is really hot, so don't be discouraged by the fact that Google and all these big companies exist.
Okay, well, if you were an element, what element would you be called, and what would your properties be?
I would be Siragium, and my properties would be dreaming big and confidence and science, scientific thinking.
Lots of managers lack an understanding of IT and what ML is capable of. In your experience, how have you best managed expectations of what is possible and what is realistic?
The standard rules apply of under-promising and over-delivering. So just you'd have to have a good knowledge of your problem domain first, and if you do, then be able to say what you can and cannot do. Don't just make BS promises, because that's going to backfire.
Do you stand for net neutrality, and how is it important to you?
Oh, for sure. The internet has to be a level playing field. I mean, I went from zero to, I think, 170,000 subscribers just on my own so far. And if net neutrality didn't exist, the top creators on YouTube would just get higher and higher in terms of subscribers, and I would still be at, you know, zero to 30,000 subs. We need it.
How do I start my journey as a tech speaker?
Somewhere, right? I mean, you always have meetups near you. Just do something small and work your way up. Build a name for yourself. Your name is your brand. Build it. Start somewhere.
Do you get sponsored by conference organizers for your talks?
I have been offered, and I've just started to do the whole speaking thing in person. I mean, I could just make videos. I'm going to start charging soon, because it takes a time time sacrifice away from my other content.
When did you start with machine learning?
It's kind of ambiguous. Like, I started in college when I was a sophomore, you know, I dabbled in it, but I only really seriously got started about a year and a half ago when I started this channel.
What problems could you resolve with deep learning technology in 10 years?
Me personally, or just in general, a lot of applications in healthcare, taking away a lot of the grunt work that doctors have to do, and also in democratizing data. There's a huge opportunity there because everybody wants data, but data isn't accessible to everybody. So any kind of project that helps with that is a good opportunity.
Do you watch any TV shows like Silicon Valley, Mr. Robot, or Westworld? And if you've watched them, what do you think of them?
I have heard of them. I've seen the first episode of Silicon Valley. It's too much like my life, so I'm not going to watch it. I actually don't have time to watch that much long-form content. I watch a lot of YouTube, but not really long TV shows.
So tell me, what role do you think practitioners of machine learning should play in avoiding bias in machine learning that may make models prejudicial towards minorities?
It all comes back to the data. Make sure that you have quality, diverse data, right? Overfitting can result in the things we've seen in the news, where there's bias in terms of race. So make sure you have diverse data.
Why isn't machine learning called statistical learning?
It could definitely be. It's just brands, right? These are just brands and stories and marketing, and we call it different things. But in the end, it's all about mathematical optimization.
What are your personal objectives for the next 5 years?
I would like to build a content machine, kind of like a Khan Academy for AI / Netflix for education, that just gets really big and gets a lot of people to watch and makes a big, big impact.
Will we solve intelligence in your lifetime?
Yes, we will, 100%. I don't even know why I had to think about that for a second. Yes, we will. We will.
What is the best resource for learning mathematics involved in machine learning or deep learning?
There's a great deep learning book by Ian Goodfellow. Definitely check that book out. Also, my channel for sure, the Math of Intelligence series, watch it all. Those are the two best ones.
In terms of the current market, which jobs would you think would get first affected by artificial intelligence?
Anything that is just people don't like. Any jobs that people don't like. So anything like call center support or cashiers as well. Cashiers.
In terms of the current market, which jobs would you think would get... I said that one. 33. If you were stranded on an island for life, which three apps would you choose and why?
I would choose Twitter because I absolutely love Twitter. I would choose Facebook just because, yeah, social media. And also Reddit because I love Reddit.
How important are data structures and algorithms for machine learning? Will it lead me to be deep learning as well? I'm a beginner.
Data structures and algorithms are super important for anything you do in computer science. Definitely, if you have any interest in web development, mobile, ML, blockchain, just get your data structures and algorithms in line first and then move on to the harder stuff.
What's your view on Elon's concern about the surge in AI?
He's totally right. We need to regulate it. We need some kind of oversight in some way to make sure that the bad actors don't get too much power.
What's the project you've built that you're most proud of?
My YouTube channel.
What's the one resource which helped you get up and running quickly in machine learning?
The machine learning subreddit.
Do you have a circle of people you mentor personally who plan to grow in the field of machine learning? If yes, how can someone join?
I don't. I don't have enough time for that right now. My channel, I think of everybody as a group. Yeah.
How do you see reinforcement learning impacting the future in terms of practical applications?
Practical applications. Reinforcement learning is one of those emerging, like it's going to have its heyday. It's not right now. Maybe it's next year. Maybe it's in 5 years. But in terms of the first applications, I would say it's anything with cleaning robots or real life robots that will do some kind of disaster recovery or something that humans don't want to do.
If you could go back in time with the same knowledge you have now, when and where would you go?
I would go back to New York, to Colombia, and I would have started my YouTube channel earlier.
Is it essentially needed when you prepare for technical interviews to try to solve problems on your own without looking at solutions?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, you gotta work the brain, right? It's a discipline. You gotta work the brain. The better it gets at this algorithm stuff, the better it's gonna be for your interviews.
Hey, Siraj, you're awesome. I want to learn about machine learning, but I'm a complete beginner. Could you outline a rough idea of what I should look to do to learn machine learning?
just, okay, watch my Learn Python for Data Science series, then watch my Machine Learning for Hacker series, then watch my Intro to Deep Learning series, then watch my Math of Intelligence series, in that order.
What math courses have you taken?
I mean, on and off, I've taken some calculus courses, linear algebra, here and there, online, at university, in high school. But in the end, the best way to learn this stuff is to just, Khan Academy is a great resource. Let me just put it very simply. Use Khan Academy for your math essentials.
What do you think about the latest achievement of OpenAI's Dota playing agent?
Oh my God, that was so badass. That is very cool. I'm so glad that OpenAI did that. They are back. They are hot right now. So I think it's awesome.
Do you think that a master's degree is required to work in big companies, or is a bachelor's in being good enough?
Being good is enough for the right companies. Of course, there are always going to be companies that really care about your credentials, but the best companies care about what you can output. So make sure you have your GitHub full of great projects.
How many hours a week do you work and study?
Oh my God, I work at least 80 hours a week. I am a workaholic. I work Monday through Saturday. I take Sunday off, but sometimes they even work on Sunday. Yep.
Can you juggle three balls?
No.
Who is Siraj Raval?
The first of his kind.
What is intelligence? How far are we in solving it?
Intelligence is the ability to adapt and to learn, and we are, I would say, 5 to 10 years away from solving it.
What are GANs?
Generative adversarial networks are a technique invented by Ian Goodfellow that have two neural networks duel against each other, and the result is being able to generate data types that have not been possible before.
You're about to get into a fight. What song comes on as your soundtrack?
Fight Music by Eminem. This kind of music, use it. Anyway.
What languages can you speak besides programming ones?
English, Gujarati, which is a dialect from North India. Hindi, which is the language of India. Spanish from high school. I grew up in Houston, Texas. Shout out to Houston. And I worked at a flea market with my dad, just selling cell phone accessories. Talks about, I had to learn Spanish. So Spanish, Hindi, Gujarati. And I'm learning Dutch. We'll see how that goes.
Would you ever go to Mars?
Of course I would go to Mars. I am just waiting to go to Mars. That's going to happen for sure. Elon, if you're watching this, you know what the deal is. So check, yeah.
How do I get into research without a master's or a PhD?
Yo, okay, so my thing is I am trying to democratize research, right? So I haven't really gone into that field, but we're getting to a point where anybody will be able to publish research online. I'm trying to grow the amateur research community. You don't need to have a PhD to publish valuable research. We're going to get to that point. In terms of what the progress so far in that field, I would say it's distill.pub.
What do you do for a living?
I make YouTube videos. I make, you know, some money off of ads and Patreon and my deal with Udacity that I just did.
How do you think blockchain and AI can be implemented together?
Oh my God, great question. OpenMind by Andrew Trask, check that out. Great example. Filecoin is another great example. Anytime you want to create a decentralized application, AI can be used to make it more autonomous. These are all blockchain and AI are just technologies to make autonomous software.
What inspired you to get into AI?
I was traveling through India and I saw a lot of problems that I didn't think would be solvable in my lifetime. And I just came to the realization that the only way we're going to really solve all these problems, the only real chance we have is to solve AI.
Who is your greatest inspiration? Why?
It's a tie between Kanye West for being a creative who is unapologetic and Andrew Ng.
What's your daily routine?
I wake up at 8 a.m., I drink some coffee, and I start writing and programming and editing, and sometimes shooting if I'm shooting a video. And I do that until 9 or 10 p.m., on and off.
Suggest some good books you think people should read.
Some good books people should read. Read the deep learning book, I already said that. Read How to Create a Mind by Kurzweil. And one more. Superintelligence by Bostrom, Nick Bostrom.
What was the best advice you've ever been given?
Also Sapiens by the book Sapiens. The best advice I've ever been given is every time you have a decision, it was actually by my hairdresser. He said every time you have a decision and you think the harder choice, the more risky choice is going to be worse, it never is. So just take the leap and do the riskier thing.
What are the coolest libraries you use often?
TensorFlow and also PyTorch. And I have been really getting into decentralized applications, so I would say Truffle and OpenZeppelin and Ethereum.
How can deep learning help in solving unanswered questions in biomedicine?
Yeah, I mean, you could use generative models to generate new types of medicine. You could use discriminative models to detect diseases that exist. So both of those things.
What do you think about Andrew Ng's new course on deep learning?
I think it's dope. I support anything that he does. We're trying to democratize AI, so definitely check it out.
What do you think about the future of decentralized applications?
The time is now. It's happening.
And do you think machine learning and deep learning are just overhyped by tech giants? Can it really solve general and super AI in the future, or is another AI winter coming?
Statistically speaking, yes, another AI winter is coming. We don't know how long it's going to be. Deep learning could be the path forward. We don't know. Personally, I think one-shot learning is going to be the field that is going to be the next step after deep learning, where we need less data for the same results. But it's a very exciting space, and as long as we have attention and we have hardworking people in this space, it's going to keep accelerating.
Cool. Well, thanks for answering all my questions and showing me around.
Awesome. Thanks, Dan.
Yeah.
See ya.